Hi, I'm Mike Bossy. As official spokesperson for Team Canadian Tire, I am proud to be associated with a corporation that genuinely cares about the proper development and safety of all of you who play hockey. The Team Canadian Tire approach is to promote four basic principles: skill development, participation, fair play, and fun. There is no question hockey is a physically demanding contact sport, but by staying fit and playing fair, you can minimize the risk of injury. This smart hockey video reinforces Team Canadian Tire principles. So remember Team Canadian Tire's message: work hard at keeping in shape, play the game fairly, above all, remember to have fun. That's what hockey is all about.
Hockey. It's fun to watch and play. It's one of the most skill-demanding games in the world of sport. And it's a body contact sport. But when hockey contact hurts, or worse, injures, the fun goes out of the game. Pros who play this game for a living are very good at making and taking a hit. It's their business, and they know how to avoid most serious injuries. But all players should learn how to protect themselves and how to protect other players. It's just smart hockey. If you use the techniques that Mike Bossy, a great pro player, shows you in this video, you'll be playing it smart. You'll be doing things to ensure the hockey you play stays fun and free from serious injuries. Trying to keep hockey fun has become more important in recent years because some very serious spinal injuries have been creeping into the game. Here's Dr. Charles Tatter, chief neurosurgeon of the Toronto Hospital, who heads up the Canadian Sports Spine and Head Injuries Research Center.
Our research shows that the most common way in which a player injures his spine or spinal cord in hockey is by being checked or pushed into the boards head first. He doesn't see the check coming, and he's crashed into the boards. The top of his helmet strikes the boards, and that force of impact is transferred directly to the spine and shatters the spinal column. This is what the human spine looks like. It's made up of individual bones called vertebrae with discs in between the vertebrae and held together by muscles and ligaments. The lower part is the lower back, this is the upper back, and this is the neck. And this is where most of the serious hockey injuries occur, in the neck. And these are the injuries that we've got to eliminate. This is a model of the neck, where most of the injuries occur, showing the bones, the nerves coming off the spinal cord. This is the spinal cord in yellow. It's the spinal cord that carries the messages from the brain to the arms and legs. These bones are not very big, and on the type of impact we talked about, they can shatter. I'll show you what they looked like on the x-ray of a hockey player who broke his neck. This is the normal part of the spine here. This is the site of the fracture, and you can see how these bones were crushed together by the force of the impact. Fragments of the bone are lying here, and other fragments were pushed back into the spinal cord and crushed the spinal cord. That's the type of injury that can leave a hockey player in a wheelchair for life. That's the type of injury, as I said before, that we must eliminate.
That's why the Canadian Sports Spine and Head Injuries Research Center made this video, to make hockey players more aware of the risks of body contact in their game in an effort to eliminate serious spinal injuries. Mike Bossy, one of the NHL's brightest superstars, had his career cut short by a back injury. Today, Mike more than ever believes that we have to teach our up-and-coming players to play smart hockey so that they'll avoid injuring themselves and others.
Folks, we all know hockey is a contact sport. You expect to be body checked, and you have to be able to take it. Nobody wants to play a sissy game. But that hitting from behind, which causes these severe spinal injuries, isn't hockey. It doesn't take courage to hit somebody from behind when he has no chance to protect himself from injury. And as well as being a gutless play, it's downright dangerous.
Stop and think. How would you feel if you hit somebody like that and he wound up in a wheelchair? Dr. Tatter is right. All hockey players should learn how to protect themselves and how to protect the other players on the ice too. That's smart hockey, and that's what we're going to look at now.
In school, when you play it smart, you go for A's. And when you play smart hockey, three A's are very important: attitude, awareness, and actions. And as this video unfolds, you'll see what I mean.
But first, protecting yourself starts with wearing properly fitted equipment. But do you know that even the best equipment can't protect players from all injuries?
That's right, and that's a real danger today. Some youngsters think they are totally safe, unable to get hurt in their hockey suit of armor. But this is just not true, and youngsters must be made aware of this fact. All the CSA-certified helmets prevent cuts and bruises and do what they are designed to do, but the manufacturers cannot make a helmet this size which will protect your neck and spine if you go headfirst into the boards like this. They say to make such a helmet, it would have to be taller than a top hat and would be completely unacceptable to players.
Next, be aware that properly preparing the body before starting to play is another protection against injury. Things such as stretching before going on the ice and building yourself up away from the rink, and this includes the muscles in your neck area.
Many younger players think this pre-ice stretching is an unnecessary waste of time. They're wrong. And when you're working out, don't forget your neck muscles. A pamphlet detailing neck strengthening exercises comes with this video. Now, with the help of some up-and-coming players, I'm going to show you seven on-ice things that you can do, make that you should do, to keep the body contact part of your hockey safe and fun. And running all through these seven tips are those three A's: your attitude, your awareness, and your actions. First point is to make sure when we're going into the corner to look over both shoulders to see where the opposing players are. We also want to take the time to look and see where our own players are. So going into the corner, look right, look left, make sure you know where everyone is.
That's awareness, and that's one of the A's of smart hockey.
Our next point is retrieving the puck in the corner. We don't want to be standing still. We want to see where the players are coming from. Retrieve the puck at an angle. If you're going to be hit, you want to be moving.
Come at an angle so you can keep moving. That's an appropriate action based on your awareness.
When you know you're going to get hit, be ready for it. Keep your legs moving, drive through the check. Most important thing is don't slow down, don't stop. You're going to get the worst of it. Let's show them what I mean, Sandy.
Another action. Keep moving. Don't slow down when you know a hit is inevitable.
When you know you're going to get hit, when you've run out of room, you don't want to go face first into the boards. Make sure that you turn, you take the hit with your shoulder and with your leg to absorb the shock as much as possible.
Another action. Don't let yourself be ridden off face first into the boards. Turn and absorb the check with your shoulder and your leg.
Just let yourself be taken out, but keep two hands on your stick. If you get pushed or tripped when you're out from the boards and you find yourself going face first into the boards, don't forget, get your arms up, get your stick up to absorb the shock.
An important safety action. If something happens so you find yourself going into the boards or glass face or head first, get your arms and stick up to take the impact.
Let's suppose I'm on the red team and I'm waiting for a pass. I'm in the danger zone, 3 or 4 meters from the boards. Don't totally concentrate on the puck. Be aware of what's around you at all times so that if you do get hit, you'll be well prepared.
Be aware when you're in or entering the danger zone, which is 3 to 4 meters out from the boards. In this area, never concentrate only on the puck. Be aware of everything happening around you. So far, Mike's six tips have been about protecting yourself when you're about to be hit or checked near the boards. Now here's one more tip, an attitude tip, about protecting a player you could check near the boards.
Do not hit another player from behind. It's a gutless type of check. It's very dangerous, and it must be stopped. In fact, I believe players who hit from behind like this should receive very stiff penalties and even long-term suspensions, because the injuries they cause sometimes last for life.
Everybody connected with the Canadian Sports Spine and Head Injuries Research Center agrees. And Professor Pat Bishop from the University of Waterloo, who's done extensive testing on this spinal injury problem in his human impact lab, adds a further word of caution.
Some people think that you have to be going awfully fast in order to break your neck. Well, they're wrong. The tests that we've conducted in our impact lab demonstrate that you only have to be going about walking speed in order to break your neck. The clear message is don't let your head, particularly the top of your head, strike the boards or the glass. And whatever you do, don't do anything to the other players on the ice that would cause this to happen to them.
That's right. Play it smart. Use those seven tips and remember Mike Bossy's three A's of smart hockey.
First, start with the right attitude to play so as not to injure yourself or others. Second, always be aware. Don't focus so intently on the puck that you lose track of what's happening around you and where you are on the ice. And third, based on your attitude and your awareness, always take appropriate action to safeguard yourself and others. And of all the tips you saw, no hitting from behind is the most important, because that's when the most serious injuries occur. The ones Dr. Tatter told us about, the ones that end players' careers. Folks, I hope you've got the message. Hockey is more fun when you play it smart and keep the risks and injuries to a minimum. Remember your three A's, your sportsmanlike attitude towards the game and others, your constant awareness of your situation and potential risks, and then taking appropriate actions based on each situation.
Yes, hockey is a great game. Fun to play and watch. Let's follow Mike Bossy's advice and keep it that way.